Barry, tell me a little bit about your force field for good, and I'm thinking especially your work with the students in Texas that you've been doing.
Yeah, actually, I've been doing it all over the country, but recently I got invited to Uvalde, Texas, to do this program on kindness that I've been doing now for a number of years. And it's interesting because it overlaps with literacy in a kind of an interesting way, because a lot of schools teach kindness or have it as part of their curriculum, but it's sort of like rule-based and what I call acronym-based, where you'll have like the word
Yes.
care, and it'll be like C stands for courage. But it evolved with a song that I'd written for children called Know Your Higher Self. In the course is Know Your Higher Self, take it off the shelf, give it room to play every single day. Forget about the fight, reach for what is right. You can teach yourself to fly when you want to cry. And the song's about learning to basically find that inner nobility, the principle of kindness inside yourself, r
Yeah.
rather than simply the rule-based kinds of kindness. So I wrote that song with a friend, Jay Banta, wrote the music part. I just put it on SoundCloud, and a teacher in Michigan wrote to me, and she said, "That one song changed my entire class." I said, "What do you mean?" She said, "They were a really tough group of kids." And which usually means boys in the class. I don't know why, but I think it's boys and girls. It was a second grade class. And she said they didn't know how to learn. They didn't know how to be with each other. And we sang it every day. And we got rid of all the class rules. And we changed it with one rule:
Wow.
be your higher self.